She's leaving.
She's leaving.
Why are you leaving?
Yaya is really leaving.
Mama, you're so traumatic. Just get in the car.
This must be April Fool.
It's March.
Well, that's it. Yaya is leaving back to South Africa.
I'm leaving, guys. I'm so sad.
Yaya.
I see y'all.
I can see y'all. Let's go. We made it. She checked in. She's heading to boarding. Will you like to come back to Nigeria?
I would love to come back to Nigeria.
So Yaya is finally about to pass through and go to our boarding. No words.
This is like that moment when you were leaving South Africa.
This is like the divide.
Yes, this is the great divide.
This is the great divide.
This is the real divide. This is the real great divide.
Yeah.
I'm gonna cry.
We are really going to realize that we're missing each other until we're actually like out, because we've been together for such a long time. Come here.
Yeah,
pick up. Mine's going to come later. Mine's going to come later because you're still here.
Yes, we're doing. How much your makeup will over your shirt?
That's fine. You can always get a new shirt. You can put all the makeup you want on me, actually.
I
got
to
come. Okay, yeah.
Before I start crying even more.
Hello wonderful people, welcome once again to this channel. It's your girl Clara. So Yaya is leaving Nigeria finally. Oh my goodness, I go miss some sham. At least for the few days she has been here, like she created content with Marvin. Oh, this was so lovely. So I have a question for you people. I want to know what you guys think about these people's relationship. Do you guys think that Marvin is a playboy, that at the end he might not date Yaya, or maybe he might consider the age factor, or do you think that Marvin is taking Yaya to be his kind of family, like he's taking her like a family friend, not romantically attached to her? Or do you think that Marvin might consider age factor? Like, I want to know, because Yaya is a very lovable person, very straightforward in dealing, so I like her way of life. Or would Marvin consider age factor? Like, guys, just drop it at the comment section. Let's just take a look at it, because we learn every day. So wonderful people, I'm going to let you guys take a look at Tabang and Khosi.
I'll see you later. Alright.
These guys, they like keeping us on suspense. I'm not getting what's going on. We are out of patience. Can you guys just kiss so that we can have peace of mind? Every time. See, our expectations are high. Khosi and Tabang, make una stop playing with our brain. So, we thought yesterday these people are going to finally exchange saliva. But we never knew that they like all this slow motion of the thing, like Telemundo. Not even Telemundo, Z World. They'll be staring at each other. At the end, they move apart. So guys, our expectations yesterday was void, but we are still hoping. So I think maybe Khosi is still looking at Tabang as that little boy of ours. You understand? Maybe she's scared of being, you know, she doesn't want to be sugar mommy. So let's take a look at Khosi's diary section yesterday. Khosi said, while growing up, she always loved herself so much, but she never knew she has big mouth, big nose, and big eyes. And sometimes people don't perceive that as beautiful. She said, I have always thought I was beautiful until I started listening to the external noise and I had to build myself up. Oh, wow. That's confidence and smart. So, guys, I'm going to let you guys listen to what she says.
But when I was growing up, I think everyone does. I think everyone looks at themselves and they pretty much content with how they look. And so people start saying stuff about them.
Joke apart, Khosi is beautiful. Even though facially she's not, but body-wise, she is beautiful, well-structured.
But as a kid, I didn't know I had big lips. I didn't know my nose was too big, or, you know, those things. Like, you start hearing stuff from people saying stuff about how they perceive you.
Khosi has really sold herself so well. She's so bold, outspoken, confident and smart. Beauty, they say, is in the eyes of the beholder. This is the more reason she got more fans, because she's fearless and confident in her skin and body, and more reason why she attracts more attention in the house, even more than those claiming to be beautiful bodily and facially with zero achievements. I know that, you know, in life you are not supposed to be complete. That is it. That one na sure banger, you understand? So listen to another gist from Mama Khosi.
And then you start maybe doubting yourself, you start like not liking certain things about yourself, but that comes from the outside, and then it starts affecting you. Then you start looking at yourself differently.
Let's take a look at this comment from Bukas_Tony. This person says, like she is saying a new thing. Who no fine, no fine. People are terrible, sha. Fans, make una calm down. When it comes to beauty, no one is perfect. Her beauty might not be up to your expectations, but she have the best bangy body in that house. Honestly, this person need to take note. I don't know what people refer to as ugly, shall, because girl, you are beautiful. I'm also a woman, I'm ugly, but then at my own part I am beautiful, and I can attest fully to the fact that you are so perfect. Honestly, they say monkey no fine, but in mama like her. That's not pinching. You no fine, but who go like it day, who go die for you day. So that's the matter where they ground. Don't just look down at yourself. You are beautiful, girly. So wonderful people, thank you for listening. Oh, please subscribe and also turn on bell so you can be getting daily gist. Yeah, bye for now.